So it's like you prevent yourself from releasing oxytocin in your brain. You just refuse to engage at an emotional level. You know, that's what hookup culture is, that I don't, in college we are too busy, we have this academic curriculum, I can't be caught in any relationships. So just let's hook up and they don't, yeah. And it's yeah.
Is there an honor for that? I'm afraid the other time here, you know, people have gone out of this dating relationship as a way to sort of get to know the person and make a decision.
Right.
But if you add the sexual component very early on, maybe you can develop the emotional attachments that no longer you're really making a decision.
Well, from my understanding, I think the youth of today may go to great extents to not get emotionally engaged, you know. In our society, like when we were growing up, it was different. It was, you were proud to be in a monogamous relationship or a long. And nowadays, it is, you're not proud to be in a relationship, you know. So they just prefer the hookup culture. And they don't want to get involved. They refuse. They actively make sure that they don't get emotionally involved.
So isn't that
really
like the
lobster? Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I was going to say, to address that kind of an issue, looking at anthropological studies, looking at cultures in different places.
Right.
You can do a better feel for other kinds of options and what does happen from them. I believe there are many, many cultures currently in the past where what we see going on now has gone out to young teenagers, teaching at very young years.
You're right.
I'm not an anthropologist, so I can't tell you, but I think it got really bad.
Yes.
I have a question. So does the body make, is there any natural counterpoint to oxytocin? As you said, you can actively say, I'm not going to associate.
Right. Whether something else is released in the brain, I don't know.
Is it a fear?
Right. A fear of commitment.
Trust.
Yeah.
So if fear releases some antagonistic proposition.
Yeah, then I would think of CRF. Yeah. Oh. You know, corticotropin release.
It's interesting that you observe the reluctance of people to get engaged, and at the same time you're working on something, thank God, that can help people with autism become more engaged. That must be wonderful for you.
It's nice to discover things. It's nice, definitely. And it is an absolute pleasure to bring it to the public.
Aren't you supposed they did the experiment with the people remote from one another as opposed to having them in the same room?
And like, that's one... So if they've done this, they've done it that you're seeking, if the person plays an investment game with a computer, then nothing happens. No oxytocin goes up. But if they know there's a human being at the other end, then it goes up. And they probably have done some, there are other studies they have done human, you know, trusting each other.
But this will also eliminate all
your fears. But this is, it eliminates. It's just a pure trust signal. You know, it doesn't have to do with how you look or how you, so it's a more controlled, yeah. Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
So that bonding between mother and child may be developing receptors at that point to have more of these cells, to have that rock for the heat.
Yes. But fortunately, for people who can't nurse, there's a lot more. It's just holding the baby, cuddling, tying.